Good morning. It's again time for our daily two-minute Bible reading and thought. I'm going to read from the Gospel of St. Matthew, and beginning at the 5th chapter, 33rd verse through the 37th verse. Hear the word of the Lord. Again, you have heard that it was said to those of ancient times, "You shall not swear falsely, but carry out the vows you have made to the Lord." But I say to you, do not swear at all. Either by heaven, for it is the throne of God, or by the earth, for it is the footstool, or by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great King. And do not swear by your head, for you cannot make one hair white or black. Let your word be yes, yes, or no, no. Anything more than this comes from the evil one. May the Lord add a blessing to the word. There was this pastor, and announced to our congregation at the end of the worship service, "Next week I will be preaching on chapter 17 of the book of Mark, and it's about lying. So all of you, please take time, read the 17th chapter of Mark." So next Sunday came, and she got into the pulpit, and she said, "Now I want everyone to raise their hand who has read the 17th chapter of Mark," and all hands went up. Almost all of them, anyway. And she said, "Well, that's pretty remarkable, since there are only 16 chapters in the book of Mark. And so now let's begin on this subject of lying." I don't think it's always wise for pastors to try to entrap people. But the point is, with this scripture we have here from Matthew, kind of speaks to that. And what it's talking about, it doesn't say we can't take an oath when we go into a court of law. But what it tells us is we don't need to take oaths for our words to stand on their own. If our character proves who we are, if we know someone who absolutely has always spoken the truth, they don't have to go, "Oh, I swear on my mother's grave, or I swear on this or swear on that, that this is true." We know that is true because their character is the witness to their truth. And that's what the Bible reminds us. Let's let our character be such that people simply want to believe us because we're believable, because our character is believable. May God bless us. Amen.